Hello students, in this lecture we will make the review of unit number 1 of the subject automobile engineering. Name of unit number 1 is the name of unit number 1 is here I am writing the unit number 1 name unit 1 the name is Introduction to Automobiles. Introduction to Automobiles. On the basis of this unit, I have provided to you my YouTube videos. In this unit number 1, we started with 1.1. Which was based on classification of automobile. Classification of automobile. After that, in this 1.1, we have also seen the major components of automobile. So, these are the two important contents of 1.1. After that, in 1.2, we have studied vehicle layouts. In that, we have seen FEWD, it means front engine, front wheel drive layout, then FERWD, it means front engine rear wheel drive. After that, RERWD, rear engine rear wheel drive. And last one is 4WD, four wheel drive. So these are the major four layouts that we have seen. After that, in 1.3, we have seen functions of chassis. Functions of chassis. After that, what is body? What is frame? And also along with this, we have seen classification of chassis. In 1.4, after that, we have seen body aerodynamics. So in this way, in this body aerodynamics, we have learned about what is drag, what is lift, what is thrust, after that what is coefficient of drag. So these are the some of the important terms which was related to body aerodynamics that we have seen. And last one, in last topic of this, we have seen in 1.5 alternative fuels. In this, we have studied about LPG, CNG, and hydrogen as a fuel. Hydrogen gas that can be used as a fuel. So these are some of the contents. After that, we have started with the definition of automobile. What is automobile? So it is a self-propelled vehicle. Automobile means self-propelled vehicle. It is also called as auto और मोटर कार और कार, यूजुअली फोर व्हील्ड व्हीकल, इट इज अ यूजुअली फोर व्हील्ड व्हीकल डिजाइंड प्राइमरली फॉर पैसेंजर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड कॉमनली प्रोपेल्ड बाय आईसी इंजिन. सो इट इज अ कॉमनली प्रोपेल्ड बाय आईसी इंजिन यूजिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्यूल, volatile fuels. So this way we can define the automobile. After that we have defined what is automobile engineering. It is a branch which deals with designing, developing, manufacturing, testing and repairing and servicing of automobiles. So all these factors are coming in automobile engineering. What are the factors? Designing, after that developing, after that manufacturing, after that testing, after that repairing, and after that servicing of automobile. And all these automobiles, for example cars, trucks, motorcycles, scooters, etc., and also related to it sub engineering systems. So this way we have seen the definition of automobile engineering. After that we have seen the classification of automobile, classification of automobile. So what is a different category we have seen by application? We have seen by application we have seen scooter, trucks, tractor, ambulance. These are some of the examples by application. Second category is by load capacity. By this there are two categories. One is light transport vehicle and second one is heavy transport vehicle. Third category is by number of wheels. By number of wheels we have studied its types: two wheel drive, three wheel drive, four wheel drive, six wheel drive and eight or more wheel drive. Then by using fuel, we have seen petrol engine, petrol vehicles, diesel vehicles, gas and electric vehicles. By transmission we have seen its types like conventional vehicles, semi-automatic vehicles and automatic vehicles. By position of engine we have seen engine in front, engine in rear. Then by body we have seen sedan with two door, sedan with four door, satin type of vehicle, wagon, convertible vehicles like jeep, van, special purpose vehicle like ambulance, milk van, etc. So this way this classification is there of automobile by application, by load capacity, by number of wheels, by fuel, by using transmission, by position of engine and by body. After that we have seen the components of automobile and its function, their location also. Components of automobile, in this we have seen major components like engine, battery, then transmission system, particularly power transmission system, then catalytic converter, then braking system, then shock absorbers, then fuel tank, then clutch system, then gearbox, then braking system that already seen, then steering system. So these are some of the components, or we can have the different parts of automobile. After that, we have seen the vehicle layouts, vehicle layout. Particularly, number A is front wheel drive layouts. Front wheel drive layouts. In this, we have seen front engine, front wheel drive. Then mid engine, front wheel drive. Then rear engine, front wheel drive, REFWD. Then second category that we have seen in this, rear wheel drive. Rear wheel drive. In the same way here, we can have front engine, rear wheel drive. Then mid engine, rear wheel drive. Then rear engine, third one is rear wheel drive, RERWD. These are the three types under this category. And in C, we have seen four wheel drive. In this, front engine, four wheel drive. Then mid engine, four wheel drive, and rear engine, four wheel drive. This way we have seen different layouts. Then we have seen the chassis. What is the function of chassis? Is classification chassis. We have seen chassis. Chassis is the main support structure of the vehicle, which is also known as a frame. It is also known as a frame. What is it? It is a main support structure to withstand the forces. What are the functions? To carry load of passengers or goods, to support load of the body, engine, gearbox, to withstand the forces caused due to the sudden braking or acceleration, to withstand stresses caused due to the bad roads. So this way we have seen the chassis. Then we have differentiated between frame, chassis and body. So frame is a supporting component of the body. After that, what is chassis? When the engine transmission system, steering and wheels are fitted on the frame, the assembly is known as chassis. And what is body? It is a superstructure of vehicle. So body is nothing but formed by chassis plus body. It will give complete vehicle. Complete vehicle. So this way, we have differentiated between chassis, frame and body. After that, the different loads that are acting on the frame, loads like short duration load, momentary load, impact load, inertia load, static load. Then we have seen what is aerodynamics. Aerodynamics. In aerodynamics, we have seen the different aerodynamic devices. After that, like wings, spoilers and scoops. After that, we have seen in this the concept of lift, drag, weight, thrust, like this. And last topic that we have seen here is alternative fuel. Alternative fuel. like